for centuries, rivers have been used to transfer people and goods. Even today, using rivers for heavy goods is much cheaper than the use of drains or roadways. It is comparatively less polluting and contaminating. Till a century ago, even our legendary rivers were busy waterways. With the advent of railways, this almost came to an end. But things are changing now.
वर्तमान सरकार ने नितिन गडकरी जी के नेतृत्व में एक ऐतिहासिक नया फैसला लिया है कि हमारे देश की जो पानी से भरी हुई नदियां हैं उसमें यातायात करके कम खर्चे में माल ढोने का पूरा अभियान चले और उसी के तहत कार्गो ले जाने के लिए पूरी व्यवस्था विकसित हो रही है। हाईवे है, एयरवेज है, रेलवेज है, अब आपके सामने है वॉटरवे।
The Honorable Prime Minister's idea and dream is being brought to life through the efforts of waterways development. Apart from existing 5 earlier declared national waterways, present government added 106 new national waterways in the year 2016. Declared a national waterway in November 2008, NW4 was initially 1,078 kilometers long. But after extension, now it stretches to 2,890 kilometers. NW4 is spread across states of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Karnataka, and Puducherry on River Krishna, Godavari, Buckingham, and Kakinada Canal. IWAI is putting its heart and mind to develop this waterway in order to provide impetus to economic activities along the different courses of NW4. In January 2015, then Minister of Urban Development, Honorable Vice President Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu, also attended a meeting organized by Inland Waterways Authority of India at Vijayawada and assured every possible support by the government towards development of National Waterway 4. On 14th of April 2016, a memorandum of understanding has been signed with Government of Andhra Pradesh for the development of NW4 along the stretches across Andhra Pradesh. Stage is set for the commencement of development activities in the first phase covering Muktiala Vijayawada stretch on the River Krishna. Survey of the entire phase 1 of NW4 is done. To maintain least assured depth, contracts have been awarded for dredging work along Harishchandrapuram, Chamaru, Muktialaya course of the river. Once operational by the year 2018, this stretch is going to be a major game changer. Cement, steel and sand worth several thousand crores would be transported to Amravati across this waterway. Save huge road transportation cost, reduce carbon footprint, create new employment opportunities. Under phase 1, 4 passenger terminals will be erected at Durga Ghat near Vijayawada, Bhavani Island, Amravati and Vedadri. 3 permanent cargo terminals at Ibrahimpatnam, Harishchandrapuram and Muktiala will facilitate cargo movement along and across River Krishna. Under phase 2, Eluru and Kakinada canals along Vijayawada-Kakinada integrated with River Godavari from Rajahmundry to Polavaram are proposed to be developed. This span is set to directly connect agro regions of connected area to the port and boost the export of agro products by providing competitive edge over other Southeast Asian countries. In the subsequent phases, other stretches of NW4 will be undertaken for development and expansion, like Buckingham Canal and remaining tracts and regions along rivers of Godavari and Krishna. Laudable efforts of IWAI towards the development of cruise tourism are showing results on different waterways across the country. These success stories will definitely be repeated at National Waterway 4 also, ensuring promotion of tourism and pilgrimage tourism. IWAI is gearing up to transform National Waterway 4. A shining future is calling, and National Waterway 4 is all set to emerge as the major catalyst to revolutionize the life of people along the rivers of Krishna, Godavari, Buckingham and Kakinada Canal.